All right. So here you can see I'm on my profile. We're going to talk about the cover photo. And if right now you're looking at the desktop view and it's pretty compressed. And the reason why is because on mobile view, this doesn't get compressed, but it gets cut off. So there's a lot of space over here that is pretty much open so that it can look really great on both of them. And the profile picture kind of enlarges on the cover or on the mobile view. And I do have a template for you to use so you can follow along and make sure that it fits in there correctly. So depending on what you're going to offer, you can have your photo of yourself over here or over here in the middle, but make sure that, you know, it looks really great when you're actually seen on mobile and not cut off halfway on mobile, but it looks great on desktop. You may think it looks great on desktop, but a lot of stuff gets cut off on mobile. So again, I have that cover photo for you. So you can see right here that the image hasn't really changed. So that's why it's really important to have that kind of like the bigger banner for the desktop view. So it again, Facebook doesn't compress the photo. It just kind of cuts it off. So you want to make sure that everything is in the right place so people can see it. And then you can see that this is a lot bigger than the image that is on desktop view. So it's just make sure that everything is in the right place. And again, I have a template for that. So let me go ahead and tap on that photo. And people want to maybe click on it and take a look at it. So they're going to go view profile cover, and this is where they're going to get the information and they're going to be able to read that. So you want to make sure that you have this missing piece of the puzzle that most people are missed. So then don't put any links in here because nobody can click on it. You just put it in the text here. All right, so this is what the template looks like. It's totally, I have a link down there so you can, opens right up to Canva. You can edit and then you can download it, edit it to the way that you want it to look. So then you can kind of get an idea of where to place things. You can edit the text and anything like that. So then you can use that, just kind of get rid of all these other texts because I'm just showing you that this is space here. So this is desktop. So make sure you fill this space with something. And what's really neat is you can use by searching gradients, go to elements, go to gradients. Where is it? All right. So then find the one that looks like it's faded. So you can choose to do that if you'd like. And then you see how it has a faded look to it. I'm just going to flip it horizontal. So then, you know, make sure it's the same color as your background as best as you possibly can. And this is where it can kind of either fade to whatever color it is that you want to use and it'll look really sharp. So that's gradient. Make sure it looks like that. And then you can change the color to gray, black, whatever it is, or fade to white from that, or let's have it on this side. So then it does fade to white. Usually I'm on dark mode, so I'd probably do this as black. If you have a different color other than black, I would just definitely use this fade. But if it's just like, you know, I just have it just solid black like this. So I didn't really need to do that. It's white right here anyways. On mobile, it's dark mode. So yeah, so you can just choose to do that. I think that's just a really cool way to show it to you. So I have a link for you down below this video so you can use that. And then make sure that your cover photo is pretty much a perfect fit.